Good afternoon everyone. So we have completed the cell chapter. Please read that chapter very carefully. This is very important for your examination, okay? The MCQ type question will come in your upcoming exam from this chapter. So read that carefully. And today we will discuss about the tissue chapter, okay? Revision portion will be occur. So first one, tell me what is tissue? What is tissue? Anyone tell me what is tissue? I will revise the cell chapter again. Don't worry about that. What is tissue, anyone? Good afternoon, everyone. Naim, Ronit, Amrita. Thank you so much. Response me. What is tissue? Write down on your board. Yes, similar kinds of cells. Our group of cells function together for a specific function. Yes, that one is called the tissue. The group of cells that are similar in structure and work together to for a particular function. Thank you so much. Group of cells function together to perform a specific function. Okay. Yes, I agree, Ronnie. Thank you. Usually the particular kind of one of the structural material of plants and tissue. Thank you so much. What is the functions of the muscle cells? Anyone tell me what is the functions of muscle cell? What is the function of muscle cell? What is the function of not only contraction and relaxation? Amrita, complete the answer. That contraction and relaxation for the movement of our body parts, okay? That is actually the functions of muscle cells are present and anchored with the muscles and with the bone due to the movement, helps in the movement of the body parts for the movement, okay? Thank you so much. Contraction and relaxation, Ronit, and contraction another part and relaxation another part, and why they contract and relax? For the movement of the body. Complete the answer. Contract and relax for the movement of the body. What is the function of blood? Anyone, what is the function of blood? Naim, try to respond. Function of blood, what is the function of blood? Yes, transportation actually helps in the transportation of different materials, food materials, water, medicines, hormones, anything, the different parts of the body is reached to through this liquid connective tissue, that one is blood, okay? Thank you. Thank you, Amrita. Next one, tell me one difference between plant tissue and animal tissue, only one difference. Right. One difference. Between animal tissue, not cell, okay? Animal tissue and plant tissue. Yes, most of the plant tissues are dead and most of the animal tissues are live, because animal can move from one place to another place and their flexible cells are present in the, and living cells are present in the animal's body. But plants are stationary, they can stand just only one place, fixed in one place. So that's why they need some strength, rigidity, turgidity. So that's why they need the dead cell for the strength. So that's why the maximum plant cells are dead cells and animal cells are living cells. Okay. Yes. Thank you, Ronit, Rajanna, Amrita. In which region of the plant you can tell me the types of the plants? First, tell me the how many types of plant tissue are there? How many types of plant tissue are there? How many types of plant tissue? There. Two, not two or three. Tell me the name also, okay? Yes, meristematic and permanent tissue, simple and compound, not simple and compound, meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. There is the different types also are present of the meristematic and permanent tissue. Okay, I just call your name, just give me your attendance, okay? Write yes on the boards. Amrita Banerjee. Yes on the board, Mohul Tamjit. Ronit Dotto. Samrat Banerjee, everyone write yes on the board or otherwise I will absent you. Sheikh Naim. Suhana Jasmine, everyone write yes on the board. Suhana Jasmine, Nafisha Akhtar, Rajanna Banerjee, Astrapool, okay, thank you everyone. थैंक यू सो मच. Next, tell me in which regions of the plants you can find the meristematic tissue. In which regions of the plants you can find the meristematic tissue, anyone? Which regions of the plant you can find the meristematic tissue? Meristem region, obviously, that is the growth region, okay? How many types of meristematic tissues are present there? How many types of meristematic tissue? Apical, intercalary and lateral meristem. Thank you so much everyone. Three types of the meristematic tissues are present there. In which part of the plants you can find the apical meristem? Which parts of the plants contains apical meristem? Which parts of the plants contains apical meristem? Yes, root and shoot, Rajanna, both, okay, both the growth region, root parts also, that is the branch, and shoot part, that is the branch upward movement, and the root part, that is the downward movements, okay, root and shoot both. Thank you so much everyone. At the base of the leaves or internodes, you can find which type of meristem, which types of meristematic tissues are present at the base of the internodes of the leaves. Which, yes, intercalary, intercalary meristems are present between the internodes of the leaves. Thank you. Which meristem is also called the cambium? The another name. Which meristem is also called the cambium? Yes, lateral meristem. Very good everyone. Tell me what is differentiation. Define what is differentiation. What is differentiation? I have told so many times that is the definition of the differentiation. What is differentiation? Tell me the definition properly. Tell me the differentiation. What is differentiation? Yes, the process by which the cells are specialized to do specific functions. Actually, the process of taking up a permanent shape and size and functions, not only the functions, shape and size. Actually, differentiation means arrangement, okay? Cell division, when cell division occurs, it increases the number of the cells, growth of the cells occurs. But how the cells, which organ will be formed from this cell, the cells may form a leaf, that cells may form lungs, that cell may form a heart. So this type of special structure, that the differentiation, a specific shape, specific structure, and it has a specific functions, all this arrangement that occurs by the process, that is called differentiation. Differentiation means actually arrangement of the cells, okay? So the shape and size, the permanent shape, size and the functions occurs by the process, that is called differentiation. The process which cells becomes progressively more specified than normal process through which the cells mature. Yes. Thank you. Napisha, Ronnie. What is the functions of the parenchyma? What is the functions of parenchyma? is the functions of parenchyma. Provide bounce. Yes, Rajanna. Ronnie, supportive framework. No, wrong. What is parenchyma, Ronnie? Parenchyma means it contains air that helps to give the buoyancy, that helps to float on the water, mainly in the water, that is water lily, lotus, anything you can find out that, okay? Helps to float, yes. Which parenchyma is called the mechanical tissue? Which parenchyma is known as the mechanical parenchyma? Why it is called mechanical tissue? Which parenchyma is known as the mechanical tissue? Which parenchyma is known as the mechanical tissue or mechanical parenchyma? Which is known as mechanical tissue? Which is known as mechanical tissue? Collenchyma. Yes, everyone, collenchyma, because it gives the flexibility, not only the strength, give the flexibility. When you bend a branch of a tree, not only all time it will be break down, because it has the flexibility, and it is due to the presence of the collenchyma. So that's why collenchyma is called the mechanical tissue. Okay. Which parenchyma is present in the husk of the coconut? Which parenchyma is present in the husk of the coconut? Which parenchyma? Which parenchyma is present in the husk of coconut? Which parenchyma is present in the husk of coconut? Anyone? Tough, rigid. Which parenchyma is the most toughest parenchyma? Anyone response? Yes, sclerenchyma. Thank you, Naim. Sclerenchyma is the toughest. So the any type of seed coat covering husk of the coconut, that is hard in structure, because the sclerenchyma is the dead, so that's why it give the strength to the plants, it prevent and protected the plants, so that's why it is called the hardest tissue parenchyma, that is sclerenchyma. Sclerenchyma is present in the husk of the coconut. Astapul, Mohul, what happened? Why don't you respond? Aptab, tell me the two functions of the epidermis. Tell me two functions of epidermis. Shamrat, Aptab, Mohul, tell me the two functions of the epidermis. Two functions of epidermis. Tell me two. Yes, protect internal tissue and another. Yes, secrete waxy substance. Actually, it first one prevent the water loss, because cutin waxy substance covered the outer layer. Okay. Second one, prevents from the mechanical injury. Epidermis, the outer layer, so obviously the internal hemorrhage or any type of injury does not occur due to the presence of that layer. Okay, third one, it also prevents from the any type of fungal infection. There is another layer is also present, so that's why fungal cannot come direct contact with the cells. Okay, so this is the fungal protective tissue, protects. Napisha, thank you. Ashraful, thank you. What is the function of stomata? The last question, what is the functions of stomata? What are the functions of stomata? Samrat responds, what are the functions of stomata? Anyone? Rajanna, Amrita? Yes, helps in exchange of gases. And another one, get rid of the extra water from the, helps in the transpiration from the plant's body. Yes, stomata is two main functions, gas was exchange and entry as a carbon dioxide and transpiration. Okay, thank you very much everyone. Just reread the, revise the chapter, that is the cell chapter, and read very carefully the small parts of the mitochondria, lysosome, Golgi bodies, and different functions of them. Okay, so you can get that question from that chapter, so that's why you need to read that chapter. Thank you so much. Stay safe everyone. Bye everyone.